All right, hello, welcome back to Saints Row. We're going to do a couple more activities today. The first activity we're doing is called Mayhem. Let's see what the cutscene's like.
Get out of here, puta. Not you, man. Sorry about that. I got a little work for you. Until I opened this club, I was a nobody. My neighbors, my family, they didn't give a fuck about me. But as soon as I had money, that all changed. Suddenly, everyone's my friend, and they all need favors. Now, I ain't got a problem helping people out, so long as they understand the consequences. If they meet their end of the deal, it's no problem. But when they don't, that's when I need people like you, Holmes. Go out there and show those pendejos why they can't fuck with Rico Martinez.
Alright, so we've been hired by another upstanding citizen of Stillwater to help him out. Mayhem basically is, they give you some weapons, and you kill people and destroy objects and blow up cars, and you earn money for each thing you destroy, and you try to hit the target amount of money in the time they give you. Pretty straightforward. There's a couple different strategies for Mayhem. The very first way is to find a fence and drive through the fence. Every time you hit a section of fence, it puts your combo up pretty quickly. You can just see the money I'm racking up here. And the combo lasts for a little bit, you know, even though I get stuck here. I've been driving kind of a wimpy car. I get back on track pretty well. So, yeah, kind of anticlimactic, I know. Fences. Yep. Oh well. Now the second, another way, that's a little more interesting to watch and to do, and if you don't have a lot of fences available, is to get out of your car and start killing people. For this particular instance, I actually get a bonus if I use the shotgun. So a few things need to happen for this to really work. The first thing is, you need to make sure the pedestrians are respawning pretty quickly. And also, the quicker you can get the cops coming after you, the better, because they'll keep sending cars and police officers after you. And they can help you keep your combo up. You don't really get as much crazy combos as quickly. This is a little more time consuming. But, you know, it's pretty fun too. You notice everything they give you has infinite ammo. You know, they want you to succeed. They really, really do. The way I see it, Mayhem is basically the game saying, look, we know why you bought this game, right? You want to take advantage of killing people and destroying stuff. So here, take these weapons, take all this ammo, just do it. We know that's why you're here. So why would we stop you? So you can see, I got this nice shotgun. Again, the shotgun takes out cars pretty quickly. So there's a lot of car parts on the ground. And you know, my combo's not that great. But I'm keeping it pretty well. And I'm getting pretty lucky with pedestrians and NPCs spawning pretty regularly. In fact, I'm just about dead, even though my combo's gone. It's been reset a couple times. I think I'll be okay. Okay, so in this instance, we're back to the airport district, which is where the first level was, so that means plenty of fences for us. But there's also a couple of interesting bonuses we get. Bonus for destroying sedans, and a bonus, wait for it, for killing civilians, which is pretty much the game saying, hey, we want you to beat this level. And it's like, okay, why not? And you can see, you'll know when you enter the territory you're supposed to be in, because everyone gets a big red arrow over their head, which means, hey, if you destroy me or kill me, you'll get a bonus. Now, a lot of these pedestrians are kind of actually really annoying at being able to jump out of the way. Or if you're not going fast enough, you don't kill them. So it's actually not that great. Pedestrians are actually really, really annoyingly good at getting out of the way. So I go back to my old fence standby. But I do mix things up a little bit in this video. You know, as exciting as watching me very slowly knock down fences before my momentum stops completely. It's time to show off a little another weapon. This is an assault rifle. You know, if you have infinite ammo, might as well enjoy what you can. Nice and accurate, good damage, long range. Also get some Molotov cocktails. I was hoping I could destroy some of the fences without driving through them, but alas, the explosives I have do nothing. No weapons I have can destroy these mighty fences. Just my car. If you notice, the more money you have to raise, they do give you long, bigger time limits, which is nice. But you see, this is, if it weren't for the fences, this would be a pretty crappy spot because not very many pedestrians around. That's kind of the problem with Mayhem, is that, you know, it's a really cool concept and really fun, but depending on where they want you to do it, it might just not work very well. I mean, if the people, if you don't have things to destroy, how are you supposed to raise $350,000 to destroy them? Thank God for fences. And the police car is a lot better than my others, even though I have a tough time steering it. Just keep overcompensating on the turn back inside. But I'm still making a pretty decent amount of money off of that line of fences there. I'll show off the airport a little bit. That's actually really not much of the airport. So you can see that police cars have the red arrow. That's because they're technically sedans. And you know what I said about the shotgun being able to take out police cars? Well, it also turns out that if you have a submachine gun and you empty the entire clip into a police car, that'll take care of it pretty quickly too. You can also see my combo still lasting. I think the higher your combo is, well, it seems to be a little inconsistent actually. Sometimes I feel like my combos when they're low go down quicker than my high combos, which I feel like should go down quicker, you know, high risk and reward. Not really sure. Fortunately, I have enough fences and pedestrians here to get me through the rest of the level. Nice little clothing bonus. Here's where things start to go sour. No fences, a few pedestrians, but not that many. I don't have any police coming back to me. I'm also on the border of the territory, so it keeps yelling at me to go back, even though I'm technically in it. I'm just on the side of the street. So here's where I go wrong. You know, I have enough time to cruise around and find stuff. If I see these cars and I figure, I'll just start blowing up cars. But I get too little good, and I forget one crucial thing. Is that what goes up? It must come down. Yeah, having a flaming car dropped on me doesn't really work. So I'm smoked. That's okay, though. All that really happens when you die, you died, is you start at the nearest hospital, and you lose a little bit of money. But that's okay, because I don't really need to buy anything right now, because I'm still doing activities. So the other activity we're going to do in this video is insurance fraud. And like I was saying about, well, we'll talk about insurance fraud quite a bit. Let's just watch this cutscene first.
Nice to meet you. I'm Dr. Raymond Gonzalez. I do a lot of consulting for this law firm, and my testimony in court has cost insurance companies millions. Here's the way it works. You throw yourself in harm's way, I write a totally accurate insurance claim, and we all walk away a hell of a lot richer. Almost sounds too good to be true, right?
Well, maybe. So this is insurance fraud. What it basically is a ragdoll physics simulator. You press right trigger or left trigger to take a dive, and this usually means jumping in front of a car or jumping off of a building, and you earn money every time you take a dive. You earn more money based on how far you fly, how many things you hit, how many times you bounce, all that good stuff. Sounds pretty fun, but there are a few problems with it. The first problem is Everything you do has to take place in a designated scoring area. If you take a dive outside of the scoring area, you earn no money for it. The problem with this is, depending on where you are, sometimes there's just nothing to fall on. So there's this van here, but then I go through quite a dry spill where there are no cars. And how am I supposed to earn money? Complete the instance if there are no cars. So that's problem one. Second problem is the cars that come sometimes are too slow, so if they hit you, or if you jump in front of them, they'll stop. Or sometimes the fast cars, if you jump in front of them too soon, they'll just turn and avoid you. Like that guy. That guy was kind of anticipating my run, so he was able to swoop away and didn't get as good as a hit as I wanted. The other problem is because you have to be really quick in getting in front of these cars. Now, because of that, sometimes it doesn't register you holding the trigger button, and you actually take a bunch of damage. If you hold the trigger button and you get hit, you take no damage, but if you don't hit it in time, you take damage. And usually, if it's a really good hit, you'd end up taking a ton of damage. If you watch my health bar in the rest of the video, you'll see there's a few hits I take where my health is really, really low. So for the rest of this video, I'm just going to switch the subtitles. This activity really lends itself well to just a best of compilation. Greatest hits, no pun intended. So I'm just going to take a back seat and let the hits speak for themselves, but I might clarify a couple things with subtitles. So enjoy insurance fraud, and I'll catch you next time.